Sunday in March of 1982, former Secretary of State Henry Kissinger returned to our neighborhood to attend the levaya of his father, who passed away at the age of 95. His children in tow, Kissinger arrived at Hirsch & Sons and then accompanied the procession to Clifton. Who was Henry A. Kissinger, and what connection did he have to his German-Jewish roots? Born in 1923 in Feurth, he arrived with his parents in 1938, narrowly escaping the atrocities of that year. They moved into a squalid apartment at 615 Fort Washington Avenue. Before long, young Hans would call himself Henry and begin studies at George Washington High School, where many of our Kahila attended in those years. Henry's father went from the position of a respected Lehrer to that of a bookkeeper. His father was a very traditional religious man. His mother had great dreams for Henry. Many of the familiar local names in our community knew the Kissingers from Feurth, including the Ettlingers, the Pretsfelders, the Bechhofers, and the Hexters. In Feurth, Henry was known as an average student, and his genius shone through only later in life. Some of Kissinger's childhood friends from Feurth remember the strictness with which young Kissinger observed certain tenets of Orthodox Judaism. Jack Hyman, now a leather crafts and toy dealer in Chicago, boarded with the Kissinger family for 5 years in Feurth in the early 1930s. He recalls one Saturday when he and Henry took a stroll beyond the Eruv. Henry stopped and reminded him that carrying was forbidden. They took their handkerchiefs from their pockets and tied them to their wrists. In the summer of 1938 in Washington Heights, they stood around the ice cream parlor at 181st Street and Broadway, or they walked the 30 blocks to Yankee Stadium in the Bronx to look at a strange game called baseball. Or they hiked to New Jersey across the wondrous George Washington Bridge, spanning the Hudson River, just to see the other side. They were German-Jewish refugee kids discovering America as millions of immigrants had discovered it before, and it was all new. Even some of their names were new. Franz became Frank, Fritz became Fred, and Heinz Kissinger, at 15, became Henry. They spoke their new language, English, whenever possible, except, one recalled, smiling, for the little jokes that you couldn't translate into English. In time, Kissinger's teenage social life took on more pizzazz, so he and his friends turned to the more liberal Beth Hillel youth group. There were girls there, refugee city girls from Frankfurt, Munich, and Nuremberg. Not Orthodox, but less strict, conservative Jews. One key to Beth Hillel's appeal was that it cut across religious lines. Its conservative congregation was small, a merger of Rabbi Heilbronn's flock from Nuremberg and Rabbi Bearwald's from Munich, joining forces for economic survival. Rabbi Heilbronn knew how to get young people involved. It was in late 1941 or early 1942, probably at a Beth Hillel dance, that Henry Kissinger's gaze first fell fully on Anneliese Fleischer. He may have been dimly aware of her at the old Jewish sport club in Feurth, but Anne had been only 10 or 11 then. As Henry drifted away from Orthodox Jewish life, he continued to attend services at Kaladath Yeshurun out of the deep respect he had for his father. Henry and Anne's relationship, though, would have to be put on hold, as Henry was drafted to the army. In the rear of our shul hangs a plaque called the Honor Roll, showing gratitude to the young men of our community who were deployed overseas to fight the Second World War with the United States forces. prominent among the names is that of Henry Kissinger and his brother Walter. Henry was initially spared fighting at the front and was sent away to university, along with other members of the armed forces who could be valuable later as intelligence officers. Eventually, though, he was rejoined with his unit of the 84th Infantry and saw heavy fighting at the front. When the war finished, Henry remained on with the occupying forces, taking the role of a valuable intelligence officer, and commandeering two cities, Krefeld and Bensheim. He showed tremendous compassion and fortitude. He had both cities entirely under his control. During that time, he hooked up again with his childhood friend, Jerry Bechhofer, from Feurth. Jerry was astounded at the command and bravery which Henry showed in his new role. Upon returning to the United States, Henry married Anne Fleischer. Henry insisted that Rabbi Leo Breslauer, his rabbi in Feurth, who officiated at his bris and his bar mitzvah, officiate at his wedding. Henry and Anne conformed to all the relevant halachos of an Orthodox Jewish chuppah. Henry was last seen in shul in 1943 wearing a private's uniform. His last appearance in the community was at the dinner for the Women's Social Services for Israel Society in 1960. Asked to talk about Israel, his speech was solely about the Cold War and nuclear proliferation. The speech was gloomy and too complex and over the heads of the attendees, in classical Kissinger style. Upon his mother's passing in 1998, Henry and his family dedicated two benches in Fort Tryon Park to his parents' memory. These were the benches upon which they would often sit. This is Henry's lasting dedication to the neighborhood. Throughout the years, Henry always came home for the Pesach Seder, and it was a favorite activity of the community youth to run up to Fort Washington Avenue after shul on the first night of Pesach to see if the limousine was parked in front of 615 Fort Washington Avenue. Many sides of Henry Kissinger, but only we know that one quiet place that he left behind for us to preserve, and the place that maybe deep in his heart he longs to go back to.